This time I got a quick gear review for you. This here is a neck protector made by Absolute Force. It can be used for fencing, HEMA, and a variety of other martial arts, be it armed or unarmed. And this here is pretty much the cheapest neck protector that I would be comfortable with recommending for HEMA practice. For Olympic style fencing, you can get away with just a mask. In case of foil or épée fencing, but for historical European martial arts where you're dealing with synthetic or steel swords with quite a bit more heft, that's just not going to be enough. And this here is, like I said, pretty much the minimum that I would recommend. It's pretty cheap. You can find it for $25. From what I can tell, the border seems to be leather right here, and in the center, that appears to be some kind of maybe nylon polyester blend, some kind of fabric. I don't think it's cotton, but it's a bit hard to tell. And on the inside, there is a plastic insert. So that's what you're getting the main protection from. You get a little bit of padding and basically relatively thin plastic in there. And it's very comfortable. You're putting it on. It's a Velcro closure in the back. And it's really comfortable. I mean, when I'm wearing this, after a while during sparring, I don't really consciously notice this anymore. As far as mobility is concerned, it restricts you slightly. Just to show you, normally I can obviously look over my shoulder. And when I put it on, I can't turn the head any further than here, which is not really significantly different, but you can notice a bit of a limitation. But for the most part, as you're wearing it, it's not really, at least I don't really feel it much. I've of course used it in sparring so far, but there haven't really been all that many throat hits, so just check it out here. Yep, a bit harder. More. Now you can see the sword is definitely flexing. If you go over there, it might be more obvious. Is definitely unpleasant, I could tell you. And you could see how much it flexes. And this would re be really dangerous, even though this is just nylon. If you get that in your throat, that's going to be really dangerous. First, another one. Oh, yeah, it's definitely unpleasant, but I'm still alive, I can still breathe.
That's what I'm doing nowadays, hitting him with steel swords.
Well, not hitting, thrusting.
That's
Okay.
even worse.
That's, you have to be a bit more careful with that because steel is, of course, a bit heftier. Yeah, I can definitely tell. Bit more. Oh, yeah, but it still holds up. So as you can see, it does the job. It is certainly far better than just the bib on the fencing mask, let alone nothing. So this is pretty much the absolute minimum that I would suggest getting. I mean, a solid thrust to the throat with any kind of practice weapon can, in worst case scenario, collapse your windpipe. So it could be lethal. This is really nothing to take lightly. While this offers both protection and comfort, I would be a bit more at ease with an actual gorget. Also, that would protect the collarbone as well. I saw there is now also a deluxe version of this one, which does actually have additional pads to protect the collarbone as well. It's just a bit more extensive protection. Costs a little more, of course, but yeah, it should be even better than this. You could probably also attach additional protection to it if you want to customize it. Like if you want to get some hard plastic, maybe with a heat gun curve it. You could even use something like PVC pipe, cut a bit out of there, heat it up, curve it so it conforms to your neck. Otherwise, yeah, if you're on a budget, that's all you can afford, then yeah, go for it. It's just, I wouldn't really recommend it against steel, not sparring at least. Your technique drills, no problem, but full force sparring with steel, this is not going to be enough. But otherwise, yeah, pretty neat. So, hope this was helpful and thanks for watching.